Hello guys, welcome to online web tutor presented by Prophetic Sessions team. I am Sanjay. Inside this video session guys, we will discuss about MySQL keys, and also we will see about what basically super key and primary keys are. So first thing first, let's discuss about what basically database management MySQL keys. So go to next tab. So what are keys? A DBMS stands for Database Management System. A Database Management System key is an attribute or set of an attribute which helps us to identify a row, means tuple, in a relation means table. They allow us to find the relationship between two tables. Keys helps us uniquely identify a row in a table by a combination of one or more columns in that table. In simple language, we can understand that MySQL keys or database management system keys is an attribute. Here, attribute refers to a column name. It means table column name. So a key is a column or set of column which helps us to identify a row or tuple in a relation means inside a table. So if I back to Chrome, and here I have opened a database. Inside that database, this is a table where we had stored a list of students. Inside this table, we have some columns like ID, name, email, mobile, course, status, and created at. So in terms of taking table as a consideration, now a key means database management system key is an attribute, means a column or a group of columns like ID, email, mobile, and so on, which uniquely identifies a record inside a table. Let's say that we are going to select a student inside this table which has an email ID called sanjay@gmail.com. So on the basis of email address, we are going to select that data. So basically this email address is known as a key. Or simply, apart from email address, if I suppose return a query something select student from this table for ID equal to 1, email equal to this email ID, and mobile number equal to this, so on the behalf of ID, email, and the mobile number, we have selected that data. So this is an group of attribute, means ID, email, and mobile. So these are also known as group of keys. So keys basically filters our result from list of data. Right now inside this table, we have few rows. Let's suppose that we have thousands of data inside our table. So on the basis of column names, if we filter that data, then those columns basically known as keys, which uniquely identifies or filters our result from list of data. So back to slide. Now they allow us to find the relation between two tables. As we know that we have multiple keys inside database, like the concept of super key, primary key, candidate key, alternate key, and the foreign key. So basically foreign key is used to attach the relationship between one table to another table. So we'll see about these keys in later videos. Keys help us uniquely identify a row in a table by a combination of one or more columns in that table. Also, we had seen about where condition. If we want to select about thousands of students, then combination of like ID, name, and email, we have filtered some data from that list. So those data on the behalf of those keys we have selected. So this is the concept of keys. Now here we have a question that why we need a key in our table. So keys help us to identify any row of data in a table. Let's understand about this point while going to table. Now let's say that we have thousands of data, and inside those data we have no key. No key, it means that ID columns may contain about the duplicate values like 1, 2, 3, again 2, again 1, and again 2. It means ID column does not contain a unique value. Name also does not contain a unique value. Email address also does not contain a unique value. Means all the columns inside this table does not have a unique property. it means email address of this student is repeated for other email addresses, means for other students. Also, in case of mobile number, we have duplicate values. So here we have a question that how can we select the means unique data or unique row or unique students from this table. So on the behalf of keys, we can select that. So to get rid of complexity or to get the unique values, we define a key inside this table because keys are unique all over the table. Keys provides the data uniqueness all over the table so that on the behalf of our keys, we can just make our query to table and get the filtered data. So back to slide. Allows helps us to establish a relationship between and identify the relation between tables. In upcoming videos, when we study about the foreign key, so in that condition, we will see that how can we make a primary key inside a table and we will use that primary key as a foreign key reference in another table. So on the behalf of our concept of primary key and the foreign key, we will do the relation between two tables. If suppose we have no concept of like primary key, candidate key, alternate key, foreign key, means here we have no means concept about these keys, then we are not going to build any relationship between those two tables. And also we have much complexity to filter our data from list of datas. So that's why we need key in our real-time database or inside MySQL. Help us to enforce identity and integrity in the relationship. It simply means that if you're going to select any data or any row inside this table, then in that condition, we need a unique row inside or unique attribute while selecting data. It provides the data integrity over relationship. Now this is the overall concept of guys keys, what we need in real time or operating with our database. Now let's see that how many keys we have to use in our database. So if we go to the next tab. Now inside our database management system, means inside our MySQL concept, we have several keys. But inside this video, we are going to discuss about only super key and the primary key. Inside upcoming videos, we will see rest of the keys. So right now, and apart from like super key A to E from this list, we have also another keys inside our database management system. But right now, from this video and upcoming videos, we are going to discuss only about these keys. So like super key, primary key, candidate key, alternate key, and the foreign key. So these are the keys basically we use in real-time database, and also we will see about the concept of these keys in our database management system. So let's start about the first thing first key about super key. So if we go to the next tab. So what is the super key? A super key is a group of single or multiple keys which identifies row in a table. A super key may have additional attributes that are not needed for unique identification. Let's understand about using of a table. So right here we are inside a table, and as we know that inside this table we have ID, name, email address, mobile, course, status, and created ad. So a super key is a column or a group of columns which basically identifies a unique record or a unique row inside our table. So by combination of let's say ID, name, email and so on columns, means by adding these columns we can create a super key. It means that while combining these keys, remember any one column or any specific column have their different value or a unique value. Let's see that I have just combined all the columns for this first record. And inside that record, we have ID of 1. While combining this second record, we got ID equal to 2. So we can make the combination of all these columns as a super key. Super key simply says that a column or a group of columns which uniquely identifies a row inside our table. Let's see that if we want to select the first record. So in where query, we will simply write that select all from TVL students where ID equal to 1, name equal to 1, name equal to Sanjay Kumar, email address equal to this ID, and so on. So it means that bypassing all these attributes of row 1, we can get only the first row data. While combining other columns while making a super key, as we know that they are not needed, but we can combine them and make as a super key. Let's see that while combining these columns means from ID to name or up to created at, as we know that the name and the course status and created at not required. But we can combine all these columns on the behalf of ID, because as we know that ID, email and the mobile number, they have unique values. They differ row by row. They does not contain the duplicate value from row by row. So we can combine all these columns. But in a combination means name, course status and created at, actually they contain a duplicate value, but while combining those values, they play an important role while making a super key. So super key is not the combination of all the columns. Simply we can say that ID, name and the email, which uniquely identifies like on the combination of like ID, name and the email address, we can select the unique data on the behalf of ID and the email address, so this pair of combination is known as super key. On the behalf of mobile number, course, status, so while combining these columns, like on the behalf of mobile number, we can select unique data, so this is a pair also known as super key. So this is the concept of super key. Super key is a column or a group of columns which uniquely identifies a row inside a table. So if I back to slide, now this is all about super key what we have discussed. Now next, let's start about primary key. So the name itself clears that the key which is primary means the main key, a column or group of columns in a table which helps us to uniquely identify every row in that table is called a primary key. The database management system primary key can't be a duplicate. The same value can't appear more than once in a table. So if we back to table, now inside this table, the column names actually we can collect about ID, email and the mobile. These are the columns which helps us to uniquely identify a record inside this table. It means that they are not going to contain any duplicate value row by row. Inside each row, they have a different value. So on the behalf of these keys only, like ID, email, and mobile, we can select any one of the columns from this list and make it as a primary key. Primary key can't be null inside a table. So as we know that, let's say that these are the data of TVL students. Now let's say that any student have no email address and also they don't have any mobile number. So in that case, ID should be means, let's say ID equal to roll number. So this roll number will be assigned to a created student. So in that case, this is the roll number seems to a primary key. By the help of this roll number, we can select any student from this list. So what is primary key? Primary key is a column or group of columns means ID or ID, email and the mobile means combination of unique columns which uniquely identifies record over the table. This is known as primary key. So if I back to slides. Now, how can we choose a primary key? And also, the DBMS primary key can't be duplicate. It means that if we are going to make a combination of primary key, then in that condition, we have to remember that mobile number should not repeat for these two students and also email address as well. All these columns have their unique value for each row. They don't contain any duplicate value. So when it does not contain any duplicate value, so on that condition, ID, email and the mobile number should be a group of primary key. Means that group we can define as a primary key and also they don't contain any null value. So back to slide. Now, how can we choose a primary key? Means what are the rules actually we have to keep in our mind while selecting any primary key? So two rows can't have the same primary key value, as we know that throughout the table means ID1 should be, means row number 1 should be for a single student, not for these two rows. So on the behalf of a unique value of this ID, we can select it as a primary key. Back to slide. Now it must for every row to have a primary key value. The primary key field cannot be null. This is also an important rule that while selecting any primary key, we have to remember that the primary key field should not contain any null value or empty value. The value in the primary key column can never be modified or updated if any foreign key refers to that primary key. Let's suppose that we have two tables, and inside this table, means inside this students table, we have ID column, and this is a primary key inside this table. Now let's say that we have another table like TBL courses, and inside that table, this ID seems to be a student ID in that table, and student ID of this table as a primary key refers to a foreign key inside that table. So we are not going to modify the roll number of any student inside this table on the behalf of foreign key concept. So also we have to remember or keep in our mind that throughout the table or throughout the modification or relationship, we have to not update any primary key while making any relationship throughout the tables. So simply guys, inside this video, we understood about what is super key and primary key. Super key is a group or single of multiple keys which identifies a record. While making a super key, additional attributes that we have taken not basically needed, also while making a super key, they are important. And also we understood about what basically primary key is. So inside this video, we have seen about all basic concepts about database management keys, what are keys, and how many keys we are going to use. In the next video, we will see about rest of the keys from this list. So inside this video session guys, if you have any doubt, then please drop your comment. I will give my reply as soon as possible. So for this video session guys, thank you for watching and have a great day.